morning. Happy Tuesday. I'm still. My voice. I don't know when I'll have my voice back. I hope you're all having a wonderful morning. I don't have anything special to say. Started on chapter 19 of the book of Luke. And Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. Behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among the publicans, and he was rich, and he sought to see Jesus. Oh, he was, and could not for the press, because he was little of stature. And he ran before, and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him, and said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down. For today I must abide at thy house. And he made haste, and came down, and received him joyfully. And when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was gone to be guest with a man that is a sinner. And Zacchaeus stood, and said unto the Lord, Behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor, and if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore to him fourfold. And Jesus said unto him, This day is salvation come to this house, for as much as he also is a son of Abraham, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. And as they heard these things, he added and spake a parable, because he was nigh to Jerusalem, and because they thought that the kingdom of God should immediately appear. He said, Therefore, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. And he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds, and said unto them, Occupy till come. But his citizens hated him, and sent a message after him, saying, We will not have this man to reign over us. And it came to pass that when he was returned, having received the kingdom, then he commanded these servants to be called unto him, to whom he had given the money, that he might know every man had gained by trading. Then came the first, saying, Lord, thy pound hath gained 10 pounds. Oh, I know. And he said unto him, Well, thou good servant, because thou hast been faithful in a very little, have thou authority over 10 cities. And the second came, saying, Lord, thy pound hath gained 5 pounds. Excuse me. And he said, Likewise to him, be thou also over 5 cities. And another came, saying, Lord, behold, here is thy pound, which I have kept laid up in a napkin. For I feared thee, because thou art an austere man. Thou takest up that thou layest not down, and reapest trusted servant. That news that I was an austere man, taking up that I laid not down, and reaping that I did not sow. Wherefore then gavest not thou that my money? Wherefore then gavest not thou my money into the bank, that at my coming I might have required my own with usury? And he said unto them that stood by, Take from him the bound and give it to him that hath 10 bounds. And they said unto him, Lord, he hath 10 bounds. For I say unto you, that unto every one which hath been, which hath shall be given, and from him that hath not even that, he hath shall be taken away from him. But those mine enemies which would not that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me. And when he had thus spoken, he went before ascending up to Jerusalem. And it came to pass, when he was come nigh to Bethphage and Bethany, at the mount called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying, Go ye into the village over against you, in the which at your entering ye shall find a colt tied, whereon yet never man sat. Loose him and bring him hither. And if any man ask you, Why do ye lose him? Thus shall ye say unto him, Because the Lord hath need of him. And they that were sent went their way and found even as he had said unto them. And they said, As they were loosing the colt, It's just not my day. I've got to get a light here. And as they were loosing the colt, the owners thereof said unto him, unto them, Why loose ye the colt? And they said, The Lord hath need of him. And they brought him to Jesus. And they cast their garments upon the colt, and they set Jesus thereon. And as he went, they spread their clothes in the way. And when he was gone nigh, even now, at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen, saying, Blessed be the King, cometh in the name of the Lord, peace in heaven, and glory in the highest. And some of the Pharisees from among the multitude said unto him, Master, rebuke thy disciples. And he answered and said unto them, I tell you that if these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out. I don't think that's metaphorical. I think that's literal. Astrophysicists say that the universe is held together by sound. Right? I heard language of cosmic strings, that the universe reverberates with sound. Sound of the spoken word, let there be light. That the talk of harmonic resonance. This physical universe, this temporal realm, is only in existence because it is energy dialed down. It's slowed down to take a physical form that you can knock on it. As I just started on the EM spectrum, where objects that are opaque to physical light, visible light, are fully transparent to radio waves, microwaves, X-rays, gamma rays, and at least on the lower end of the spectrum, below the infrared, you have Faraday cages, which are fully transparent to visible light, but are opaque to radio waves and microwaves. You know how it works. That little screen on the door of your microwave oven is there for a reason. So yes, that said, where were we? Yes, I believe that the rocks themselves would cry out to say otherwise, to say that that's not in God's skill set, I think is blasphemy. And when he was come near, he beheld the city and wept it. Well, he wept over it. Excuse me. Somebody go and catch whoever made this stuff in a bio lab. If this is COVID, get him. Actually, if it's not COVID, go get him. Saying, if thou hadst known, even now, at least in this day, or God, go ahead and take care of them. This stuff's gone on long enough. In Jesus' name, amen. Sold therein, and them that bought, oh yeah, that's one of our favorite stores, money changers in the temple. And he went into the temple and began to cast out them that sold therein, and them that bought, saying unto them, it is written, my house is the house of prayer, but ye have made it, and have made it a den of thieves. And he taught daily in the temple, but the chief priests and the scribes and the chief of the people sought to destroy him. Day.